Kia ora guys, welcome to Study Time's Level 2 strategy video for life processes at the cellular level. I'm Mackenzie.
And I'm Hattie. So a lot of students find this standard really tricky because there's just a lot of content in it, and a lot of questions will mush together a lot of the different concepts into one answer. So it's really important that you're able to identify the key ideas behind each question and break it down into those.
Yeah, so the two big overarching ideas within the standard really just is life processes and different biological ideas. So let's get into it.
First, let's run through the main processes you'll be asked about in this external, which are photosynthesis, respiration, and cell division, which can further be broken down into DNA replication and then mitosis. The key thing with all these processes is that you need to understand where in the cell they happen, what all the stages are, maybe not in full detail, but definitely a general idea of what each step involves, and also how they all interact to come together to form life.
So in understanding the three processes that Hattie mentioned earlier, we'll start with photosynthesis. Now bear in mind, this only happens in plant cells and specifically in chloroplast, which is an organelle unique to plant cells. Now in understanding the relationship between how the cells absorb sunlight, it can be really handy to know a cross-section of a leaf and understanding the different layers within it. So in particular, you would be wanting to discuss something like the palisade layer that has a lot of cells with a high amount of chloroplast. Also, a common question can be either labelling or creating your own diagram of a chloroplast, so bear this in mind as well. Secondly is respiration, and so a common mistake that students make is thinking that this only happens in animal cells. This is wrong, because respiration is the process by which we are creating energy that the body uses, so this actually has to happen in both plant and animal cells, and as we know, it occurs in the mitochondria. Thirdly, we want to understand the relationship between mitosis and DNA replication. These are not the same thing. DNA replication has to occur before mitosis can happen so that both daughter cells are diploid and can carry out regular cell function. If you're feeling a little bit unsure of this, it can be really handy as well to understand the cell cycle as a whole and the reasons why mitosis might occur.
As well as these three main processes, there are also five other areas that can be interwoven with them to form an NCA question. These are firstly the movement of materials, so that's diffusion, osmosis, active transport. Secondly, enzyme activity. Thirdly, factors affecting the life processes, so that's things like temperature, pH, sunlight. Fourthly, the purposes of each of these processes. And fifthly, the reasons for the similarities and differences between particular cells. For example, size and shape of cells, or the number of organelles in them. An NCA question won't just focus on one of these things, it will be several jumbled together. So for example, you won't just be asked to talk about the purpose of photosynthesis, you'll be asked to talk about how photosynthesis happens, what it's for, and how enzymes can affect it.
So for some strategies for success, let's discuss some of the questions that students are a little bit less confident with. So one of these is the structure of organelles. So why is it that they take the shape that they do? So if we're discussing something like mitochondria, we would be discussing the outer and inner membrane and how the inner membrane is folded to create cristae to ultimately increase surface area. Alternatively, if we're talking about this in regards to chloroplasts, we can be talking about grana, which is our thylakoid stacks, and how this increases surface area as well. Now, another thing to bear in mind is the shape of the overall organelle. So a lot of them are longer, and again, you guessed it, it's to increase surface area, so more amount of material can diffuse into the organelle at a given time. Now, another question that a lot of students sometimes struggle with is the reasons for organelles arrangement. Now, what this really means is, why is it that do some cells have higher amounts of mitochondria or chloroplasts compared to others? So for mitochondria, it might be something like a muscle cell as opposed to a fat cell. So our muscle cells, because they're far more active and they require far more energy, will have a higher amount of mitochondria than a fat cell. If we're taking this for plants, we can be discussing our cross-section of our leaf, and we would say things like the palisade layer of our leaf section has a higher amount of chloroplast than the spongy mesophyll section that has a considerably lower amount, because it's really just catching what the palisade layer kind of missed. Lastly, we need to consider things like the factors affecting our rate of reactions, our rate of the processes happening. So we can kind of think of this as it boils down to enzyme activity, but there are also things like heat and light intensity and substrate availability which affect this rate. In regards to mitosis, we also need to consider things that affect life. So These might be things like the amount of nutrients that we can get, the kind of cells that are available. So if an organism isn't getting the right nutrients and things it needs, the rate of growth of a cell is going to be considerably lower.
If you're aiming for those E grades, it's really important to understand how the questions are generally structured in the exam. Generally, there'll be about 3 to 4 bullet points. The first one will be asking you to define a key term, which is more of an achieved skill. The second will be an explanation question, which is really asking you how to relate what you've just said in the definition to the context in front of you. That can go up to about a merit. And the third and fourth will be about discussing how that's actually relevant, how a bunch of factors play into it. That's where you get those excellence marks. If there are more than one discussion point, it's really important that you answer all of those to an equal quality, because excellence answers need to show comprehensive understanding of every single part of the question, so try and devote approximately equal time and page space to both of them. Even though there's only one definition bullet point, every time you introduce a new term, you should be defining it. That said, don't just try and define all the terms you've learned over the course of the year. Make sure you're only defining terms that are relevant to the actual situation in front of you and the resource material. Finally, NCI actually sometimes gives you some wee hints about how to get a good mark, and students often miss these. For example, in the 2015 paper, there was a question about a hog choker, which is a type of saltwater fish, asking you why the concentration of salt in the water would increase the hog choker's oxygen consumption. Now, in the question, NCI had actually bolded the word active, meaning active transport. And we should know that active transport uses energy, and to use that energy, to get that energy, respiration needs to take place, so oxygen needs to be taken in. If you actually spotted that keyword and used it, you'd be able to understand how the ideas link together, how if the hog choker needed to actively transport salt out of its cells, then it would need to take in oxygen to gain that energy.
So guys, this has been Study Time's Level 2 strategy video for life processes at the cellular level. We've covered a lot, but we haven't quite covered everything. And as always, we recommend that you guys check out 3 to 4 years worth of past exam papers so you get an idea for the format and the kinds of questions you're going to be asked.
We also recommend you check out the Study Time walkthrough guides. They're available for free online or to purchase in print with next day delivery, and they're designed to walk you through everything you need to know before the exam. So, good luck!